going to have a heart to talk harder. When people began to die, no one couldn't even imagine that everything was going to end like this. Well, how did they imagine? Well, no one is ever really ready for a mass amount of the population to just fall over, keel over, and die. If that is. The Earth's population has decreased at times. Seemingly, there will be more space. The air will become cleaner. But no. Yeah, you'd think you'd lose about a billion or so people. Things might not be as bad. The man turned out to be so wild and not adapted that began to gnaw himself. Panic, looting, conflicts. Anarchy ensued. Nobody was able to take on this burden and keep control of the situation, and that's why everything collapsed. Oh, I do have camera control. In my city, people began to break the windows, steal the values, medicines, food. On the very first day, they were stealing cars, puncturing tires to others, just so they could get to the hospital first. Oh, they're slashing other people's tires. Fuck. But no one knew that the medicine was already powerless. Couldn't have been completely powerless. You're still here. I'm still here. What else can I see around here? Okay. I need to sort out things with... It'd be good to bring water from the well. We need food. Well, we just killed a fucking bear, so we should have a ton of food. Alright, so it was that little scene. Yeah, I can run around, I can do everything necessary there. Walking around at night, so I might as well make sure I got my flashlight out. But, yeah, what do you mean we need food? We just killed a goddamn bear. We should have food for days. Yeah, well, yeah, especially since we have a fire and everything like that. We should be able to get, I imagine you don't... Where is that big old bear corpse? Why would he, I imagine, block the door just to make sure that nobody came after... Am I walking over the bear? Okay, I guess I'm just walking over the bear. Okay, cool. Let's head out the back door, which I imagine will not open, so I'll have to go out the front door. And I need to find a well and gather some water. Yeah, door's locked from the other side. It was worth a try. Hey, man. Can I, like, interact with you outside of... No? Never mind. Fine. Whatever. It's not that dark. I don't need my flashlight quite yet. I didn't get a chance to really look... I don't know how much my flashlight actually helps in this situation. Though I do have a lot of, like, chromatic aberration just screwing up my vision. Making things very loopy. Unless I'm, like, a little bit drunk, that might explain... But, I don't know, there was that bottle of vodka. Vodka. Hello? Is anybody home? Khrushchev? Hey. Oh, it's just a concrete tube. I thought it was a well. I'm like, sweet, I found the well already. Imagine since I have batteries, that means that... Really? Are you not a door? Because you look incredibly untextured? That my batteries will run out in my flashlight at some point, which makes me somewhat concerned to walk around with my flashlight on when I don't need it. You know, big bright moon. Everything seems pretty damn bright. It's not like I have the brightness jacked up or anything weird like that, but... Yeah. I don't like the thought of me wandering off on my own to go look for things as you sit by the campfire all warm and cozy. Then again, you do move slower than the second coming of Christ, so I guess I am better off just scouring this town myself. I have the youth and exuberance and strength to run around this place in circles, missing the side door, not the front door, but the side door, and, yeah, it blocked off the stairs upstairs, but that seems like it was blocked off from here, so that means they prevented whatever would be upstairs from coming downstairs. That is very unsettling to me. I don't know why. You know, I thought that dogs, as I mentioned before, would be my greatest concern. But now bears, and I imagine people. People are pretty damn dangerous in themselves. And with that, I shouldn't need any... Oh, yeah, that's not terrifying at all. So now I have a lighter in my inventory. Good to know. I suppose that will be if I there's no key associated with the lighter. Can I just use it randomly, or will I need that for something else later? Got another med kit. A couple of med kits. No? Don't know if having that music playing will obfuscate somebody who sneaks up behind me and comes to hurt me, or... You know, just in case. I don't need anybody coming for me. Unwanted. I thought I could open up the oven for a moment there. Seems like it would have been a good place to find something. Ooh. This is eerie and creepy. I will give you that. Or at least I'm getting goosebumps from it. Jesus. Maybe it's just the lack of anybody around. Maybe it's the pacing. Or just how empty and desolate this whole place is. No? Can't open that? And the fact that I've been finding things and I don't fully understand their usage yet. Will I need that lighter for burning stuff? Will I need the med kits if I get my ass kicked by some sort of wild animal or wild human being? It's the wondering that I think bothers me the most. A constant and never-ending wondering. Did I just see a light up in the... There we go. Where do you... Now you lead back to the outside of the house, it appears. Sure, why not? I guess I'll just keep heading down the street until either I find this well that he's talking about, where I can... I don't know if that's an electrical box, because it's written in Russian. Find that well, gather the water, and the... what do we have here? Jar of food? Can I... Is there actually no crouching? Yeah, I'm hitting the... I just need to wiggle my way through that tube. It appears that I could not pick up that jar of what appeared to be a preservatives anyways, so... Success, but quickly evaded. Ugh. I find that unsettling how it opens towards me, and I have to get super close so it actually ends up hitting me in the goddamn face. Another... blocked off stairwell from below. So what is upstairs? And why is everybody trying to contain whatever is upstairs from coming downstairs? I still kind of like that little thought that I had, though, of everybody of a specific generation, well, beyond a specific generation, just dying and leaving it to the younger generation. That's what a lot of people claim would be the solution to a lot of the issues that we have when it comes down to new media or the inclusions or just adjusting old laws where it's like, you know, that's not applicable anymore. Oh, it's only just a bunch of old men that when they were growing up, that was an issue and concern that they're holding on to it, or how, you know, you have the... not old-minded, but people of a certain generation who are like, oh, you know, music was the devil when I was growing up, and now video games are the devil, and then, hell, I think at a certain point, even before music was prominent, books were the devil, because they were, you know, challenging people's minds, challenging the conventional thought, what was the tried and true, the old guard, and to have a... well, world where the old guard is gone. Don't need to go that far. So you did block me off at a certain point, eh? Just to be sure. Let me get my fucking knife out. I will walk around in a stance where I can protect myself because I don't have my friend nearby. And I'm not very good at getting ready to do QTEs when the moment comes to it. I found that a very interesting concept. I kind of wonder how, if, you know, society didn't collapse and a vast majority of the population didn't die and I can't open any doors while I have my knife out in a pandemic like that. If how the world would kind of adjust and change if you just have people that were so entwined or not brainwashed, but associated with how their parents raised them and how they, you know, they wanted the world to be, how they thought the world is supposed to continue on. More batteries, that's good. Maybe I won't have to worry about my flashlight too much. That is, if there's actually resource management going on here. That, you know, I imagine a lot of things would change very quickly. Maybe they would revert back. Maybe a society or groups of people would fracture off to keep things in the status quo state or how they were before the good old days. The hippies, if you may. I do want to check out the church, but I don't imagine I can bust through that. I'll have to find an alternative way in. And here we go. Yeah, before we get a little bit further, just getting this out. Just because I don't know what's waiting for me in here. It appears nothing but a Bible. Hey, Jesus. How goes it, buddy? It's kind of eerie. The Gregorian chanting to go with this, Catholic tableau. No, a tableau, I think. Yeah, I guess that kind of fits into the description of a tableau. Alright, checked out the church. Good enough. Did my due diligence, I think. Anything behind here? Anyone behind here? My friend scared the living hell out of me when he ran past me. I think that's actually more frightening to think about. It's like you're being chased by a bear. And your friend has now outran you while you're being chased by a bear. You're dead. There's no ands, ifs, or buts about it. You're fucking dead. Shit. See? This is an effective way of keeping somebody where you want them. Not allowing them to walk up piles of wood or jump up the piles of wood due to invisible walls and just, you know, fences. Not knee-high fences, but, you know, 6-foot fences that prevent you from going any further. So I did not find a well. I did find a church with some shit in it, but I don't know what any of that meant. Another random... I think it's a doghouse, but it has no openings and there's a crank on it. Oh, that's the well. Oh, right. I see. Well, it's a good thing I took a second look at that. So I need to find a bucket. I haven't seen a bucket anywhere. I found a goddamn lighter, but not a bucket. I would hope that was in one of these buildings, but I might have walked by it. Is that... I thought I saw a hatchet for a second there. The hell is that random noise? I love how the candles sound like a raging bonfire. You hear that? Or is that just due to something weird or strange? So, buckets. Thought I was looking around thorough enough, but I guess I was not nearly thorough enough. Alright, I found the well. Good. That was just me walking through the branches. That's what that noise was. It scared the living hell out of me. Sure. Please don't say the bucket's back at the barn. Yeah, okay, that's just a rustling of shit as I walk by it. Good, 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 good. So I can't go any further there. And I don't think I'll be able to get to those buildings over there because they're probably outside of the boundary of where I'm about to walk, but I will give it a try just in case. Nope. Just as I kind of thought. That's the light I turned on over there earlier. Kind of made me think. I'm like, why? Why do I see a random light over there? Did I manage to check out this house over here? I think I did. And I believe I walked away from it completely empty-handed. We got big old drums, but I don't see buckets. Yeah, I've been in here already. I searched these rooms. We got these milk jugs. These would be good enough. Just wrap that chain around one side of it, and everything would be hunky-dory. Bucket, oh Bucket, where are you? I probably walked past it like a damn blind dunderhead. It's a big old stove. Well, I'll head over to the far side of the barn, and then I guess go back through all the houses again. Unless I was supposed to pick up the bucket that was like right beside the fire, and I just didn't notice it. Which is completely possible. Yeah, so take a loop around. I call it a barn, but it's more like a longhouse. Or not a garage. Some sort of storage area. Either way, this visual effect is kind of disorienting. I don't know if that's intentional because it's nighttime. Well, we found some food. Found some goddamn animal traps. I would love to grab that little pot. That would probably not work very well. An anvil? A hammer? I would rather be walking around with a hammer right now than, well... a knife is pretty actually convenient if you want to compare a knife to a hammer. Open up this door. I got the back door open here now, which is maybe very useful if we need to get the fuck out of here. Not too sure, though. Oh, okay, so this was a barn. Yeah, it was a barn. Kind of like what I was thinking. Cattle and all that stuff. Another tractor missing its front wheel? Seems to be a problem around here. Where is this bucket that you speak of, by the way, my Russian friend? No. Do you not know either? You're like, hey man, go find a bucket somewhere and get some water while you're at it. It's like, sure thing, I'll get right on top of that. Just wondering, if I can't find this random bucket somewhere, well, what do I do? Come back with water in mouth, spit in my mouth. It seems very unhygienic, but whatever, we survived a plague, how much worse could it get, right? Right? I don't know. It can't be that bad. Or it could be a hell of a lot worse. You never know until it comes up and bites in the ass. So nighttime, I have to do a bunch of scrounging. Daytime, I don't have to, and my vision's not impeded by whatever the hell is wrong with me. Okay. Back through all the houses, and this time, seriously looking for a bucket. Not this half-assed bucket searching that I was doing, unless there's one, like, right beside the well. And I did not notice. Got my trusty flashlight on, though. How could I not notice? Mind you, I didn't search the first house, really, did I? Because when I went up to the door, it didn't want to open. So, maybe... No, door's not opening. Do I have to find another way in? Never really gave any signs that I can go through windows. Let's just do a little bit of strafing around here. Because this is the only house that's, you know, has not granted me access to the inside of it. Hello, little bathroom window. That kind of explains that. I just completely forgot. Might have to just double check and make sure I'm hitting the right key. Yep, I'm hitting the right key. Just guess I can't go in. Oh, for a second I'm like, really? Wait. So this delivers water as well, but I still don't have a bucket. God damn it. Unless it's one of those things where, kind of like that stool I picked up earlier, it just, I don't know, it's very strange. I would imagine it would be incredibly obvious, but that's probably why I have not found it yet.
Oh, Mr. Bucket, he's my friend. Ba-ba-ba-ba.
If there's a bucket to be found anywhere, I would think it'd be here, right? This place seems to have the most bucket-like structures. Box. That looks like that would work. A kettle. Like a goddamn kettle. That's perfect. I'm up on the table. And, like, I could not think of anything more appropriate than that kettle. This little pot here. The giant milk jug. Anything. Really. And we're getting close to the light again. A coffee cup. I can at least use that little thing on the other side. That little spout, I guess. And that would be... perfect for a coffee cup. I could just put a little water in there. My friend could swirl it around in his mouth and spit it on the ground. And we'd be good as gold. But it appears that's not the case. Mr. Bucket. So I did double check that. Maybe I'll go for a little bit of a run around the exterior just to make sure I've checked everything. And then I get frustrated and I put on my give up machine. So you're the same kind of thing, right? I pull that and water comes out of it and I have nothing to put it into, so I'm SOL. I haven't been checking the outhouses, though. Am I gonna have to grab somebody's shit bucket? Is that what this has come down to? Oh, no. So I think I checked that outhouse over there. I don't believe I checked the outhouse for over here. No, it's not on this side of the house. So... it doesn't appear that they have an outhouse. Guess you gotta wander over to your neighbors and use it when you have to go, hey? Or you just walk in there and how are they supposed to know unless they, end up using it at the same time, which, you're in a small enough community. People's bowel movements could sync up. Or not. Come on, outhouse. Give me that bucket. Bucket, 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 bucket. Ugh, what a shithole. Alright, check the rest of the house then. And just click on everything that looks like a bucket. Or bucket-like. That's quite bucket-like, but not enough. Bag of sand. Ugh, love grabbing her breasts. It's like a bag of sand. That's not how they're supposed to feel. Random chairs and corners. Random chairs and corners with dust covers on them. That's nightmare fuel, you know. How about the tub? Can I just drag the tub over to the well? That could do the job, right? Right? I found quite a few things that could work as, facsimiles of buckets. Not facsimile, analog. Yes, analogs to buckets. But none of them seem to be quite right. And we got this hole that I appear to be floating over now. Thank you for that, gravity. There's lockers. Ah! I'm a blind man! Or I just really wasn't paying attention enough. And that's why I end up having to double check shit. Alright, gotcha. I'm just going to run that down. So I want a better perspective on this. I guess that's how I know I've gotten it all the way down. Now there's probably going to be something in the bucket, like a rat. Oh, god damn. I hit the button to pull out my knife. And the second I did that, it was still pulling up the chain, and the noise of me pulling out my knife scared the ever-living hell out of me. A lot. A lot. I don't want to take the camera out. I just want the knife. Okay. I'm coming back. I have finally achieved my goal. It just took me having to search practically every house twice and looking at a bunch of shitholes, but... at least I haven't been attacked by anything, he says as he walks into the barn and gets attacked by something. No, you're fine. You are absolutely fine. Cool. So. Yeah, absolutely. Not what I want to do. Nah, still not what I want to do. So do I just... Hey!
Прошу к столу.
Oh. Some sort of red sit-down mist. What the hell? Where the... Oh, from the vodka. I see.
Ну что, вздрогнем?
Cheers, comrade. Nah, I have no camera control whatsoever. Have a drink of my tea as well.
Ровной дороги на...
Oh, let's have a good trip, Petrovich. Well, it appears my name is Petrovich. Good to know. And the nightly chromatic aberration has left us. So it appears that each night, you know, things get a little bit hazy, a little bit wonky. And, I hope that doesn't become a habit. Or, I imagine the next place that we camp out, settle down, bunker down for the night will be quite different. Petrovich, you're coming, comrade. Yeah, there's... Did we at least have soup? So, doesn't appear that we used anything out of my inventory, from what I can tell. I haven't been studying my numbers, but... No, things are still a little... Maybe it's just the fog. Things are still a little funky looking. Or at least, they look really weird to me. It's, yeah, maybe when the morning light comes through. Yes, we'll reach town soon. You know how we'll reach town even sooner? By picking up the goddamn pace. That's how we reach town a little bit sooner. I could be, you know, just trying to rush things, or paranoid, pulling out a knife as I'm going out to get water, but at least I'm still alive. For now. I imagine that is the barrier to town. Why we... I guess it makes sense that we stopped at the outskirts. Oh, well, I'm waiting for you, whatever the hell your name is, random partner. I'm going to check out the houses. Because it's no longer the middle of the night, and even... the fuck? What the hell? This fucking place of... Okay. I thought somebody threw something at me, but it appears the place is booby-trapped. Alright, I just have to make sure that I'm a lot more... careful. Oh, here I am mashing E, thinking that... Or maybe it is still playing the piano. I'll just keep hitting E then. Fucking bastards. Somebody set up a damn booby trap and blew my ass up. I suppose that's what happens when you randomly run into somebody's house to, steal their shit, but can I use a med pack, or... Oh. Oh, shit. Interesting. There's some shit going on here. And everything's no longer weird and woozy, I guess. Just because I guess I was hungry. Here I am complaining about how things look weird. And then I, you know, remember, hey... blood everywhere, that's great. I have food, and I have a med kit. If I didn't get my ass blown up there, I probably would have not thought of using my med kit. Well, bad things happened here. At least, no, stairs are still blocked. Somebody doesn't want us going upstairs anywhere. And I just noticed my buddy walk by, so... I guess I'll pick up the pace, because he's probably waiting on me now. Got a scarecrow out here. What you got there, Scarecrow? I'm going to have to be a bit more careful walking into houses, if that's the case. Yeah. Huh. Well, the night would have been, I guess, a lot clearer if I decided to eat. That's annoying. And... Didn't you see anything at night? Here's fire pit. It is smoldering. You found signs of somebody who was nearby? Someone was here recently. It'd be good to check the house. Yeah, I'll come check that house in a second. Just want to make sure that there's no more booby traps in these other houses. Creepy head? Oh, the fucking moose head. There is something sinister about that moose head, you say. Maybe it contains the guts of human beings. It's just a book. I thought it was a med kit. Can I interact with the moose head? Can I hit the moose head with a knife because I don't like it? Alright, then. It appears I can do neither of those things. So... no, I can't interact with that like that. I imagine my flashlight gets dimmer as well if I'm not paying it. Well, it didn't seem like it was, but I couldn't really tell. I'll grab that. Nope, that's not food that I can grab. Damn it. Jesus, that is bright. Since the beginning of the events, my life changed dramatically. I was lucky that the disease did not affect me, but there's still a bunch of troubles. Living here is definitely easier than in the city. Subsistence farming helps greatly, because now I can't go to the store to buy potatoes with meatballs. Can't taste any cold beer. The marauders, beasts traveling from place to place, robbing travelers, do not disdain with anything. Must have completely forgotten of conscience and honor. Sooner or later, I'll have to get out of here.